we're going to get the price of Atlantic and European and Southern Hemisphere food skyrocketing. And we're going to have the poor only in America and Europe only able to eat specific sourced food stuff like Aldi and Sainsbury's that sell, because they'll be the only reason we price food stuff. Because remember, we're into a population spike because the third world, half of it's under 20. We've got the Pacific, which is an enormous supplier of food. The west coast of America and Canada have been covered with radioactive rain, which of course means the west coast of America produces quite a lot of food, I think, and the west coast of Canada produces quite a lot of food. We've got the whole of Japan, which will become a death zone, so the Japanese will have to move or die. So you can actually see that the trend is that radioactive food from the Pacific will be fed to the consumer in the West because of its low price for as long as possible, like Aldi and Sainsbury's are doing. I expect I can go around to the other supermarkets and see what they're doing. Decades from now, a lot of the poor in the West will have got fatal radiation damage, and of course we'll be producing these mutant rats. The price rise of food then will become astronomical. So we know that the future from Fukushima is the rainbow in radiation-free food. So what we get was the trend will be that we'll have radiation food from the Pacific, from large tracts of North America. And now course, I'm singing, being low price, full of radiation, and we'll have non-radiation corrupted foods, which will become less and less when the fuel ponds number 1, 2, and 3 collapse, with earthquakes over the next 10 to 15 years. So of course it's Russian roulette. When are they going to drop? We can't get people here enough to save them. And we know that cause a disaster waiting to occur. But we do know that food, not gold, not silver, not platinum, not shares.
Non-radiated food.
No, non-radioactive food will, and non-radioactive water will be the most valuable things on the planet in the future, and that only the middle classes and the rich will have availability to that, and that the governments in the West will be unable to afford to supply non-radioactive water and stuff to their poor